Today we're going to learn how to install the RepRap discount full graphics smart controller on the BigTreeTech SKR version 1.3. Okay, to point out a couple of things on the front panel that you need to know for your LCD, we have our reset button, our piezo buzzer underneath this sticker, and then we have a potentiometer that we can use to select what we want in the menu and then press down. And just to let you know, I'm not being paid to do this tutorial or sponsored, and I will be leaving Amazon affiliate links in the description for where you can purchase it. On the underside of the LCD, we have a port here for our ribbon cable. It's EXP1, and then we have another one that's EXP2. We also have a SD card reader right here integrated into the LCD. On our BigTreeTech SKR version 1, we have an EXP1 port and an EXP2 port. So to connect this up, we're going to use a notched connector. And we're going to connect that first to EXP2, and then the other side is going to be connected with the notch connector to EXP2. Then we're going to do the same for EXP1 with the notched connector, and the same for EXP1. Now that we have the LCD connected to the ribbon cables for the board and for the LCD, in order to program it, we're going to use the TF drive that has a drive right in here that integrates into the USB. So in order to use it, what we need to do is connect the big side of the USB serial cable to the board. And before we actually add power to the other side, we're going to move the jumper to the USB serial connection for 5 volts. Now we're going to connect the other side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And as you can see, now that it's powered, we have power on the LCD screen. Okay, to start with, as you can see, we have the USB drive. This is for the SKR 1.3 with the TF drive inserted. So you can see that it's got a firmware.cur, which is a cursor file. And then we also have our date and time of the last build. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go to Atom with PlatformIO. And before I get started with this, I need to show you something. In order to set this up, you need to download Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x, and you need to unzip it. Next, you're going to take the unzipped folder and open it completely wherever it is on your computer. And keep in mind, it shows right up here in the top of the toolbar the path to your file. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the Marlin folder and go to the subfolder for source, then core, and then we're going to open up boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on SKR, and the board that we're looking for is board_BigTree_SKR_V1_3. So we're going to copy that. Next, we're going to close out of boards.h. We're going to collapse these folders down and go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, we're going to do a search on motherboard, and we're going to highlight board_ramps_14_EFB, and we're going to paste what we just copied. Then we're going to scroll up to where it says define serial port 0, and in our case we're going to change it to -1. Now you do have the option of doing 0 if things don't work out for you. Next, we're going to do a search on LCD and SD, And what that brings us to is LCD and SD support. And as you can see, you have the option to choose a language. So in this case, it's English, but of course you have German, Polish, Russian, French, and Spanish, or whatever you can think of normally is in here. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to look for SD support. This is for our SD card. Now currently it's commented out, so we're going to remove the comment so that we can use our SD card. Now keep in mind that sometimes there might be issues, so you can do the define SD check and retry. That's up to you. Now we're going to search on speaker because we have a piezo buzzer. And what we need to do for this is remove the comment as well. So that's define speaker. And then finally, we're going to search on full underscore graphic. And here is the definition for our particular configuration being define RepRap underscore discount underscore full underscore graphic smart controller. So we're going to remove the comment so we can enable it. And then finally, we need to go over to PlatformIO. And as you can see in PlatformIO, currently the default environment is Mega, ATmega 2560. That's the chipset we're not using. So let's find the one that we're going to be using, which is down here. And that is the LPC 1768. So we're going to copy that. And that's for the ARM Cortex-M3, which is our 32-bit controller. So we're going to scroll back up, and we're going to highlight Mega, ATmega 2560, and we're going to paste what we just copied. And next, what we're going to do is we're going to press the upload button, which will upload. But before it uploads, it'll compile our changes, then upload. So I'm going to click this, and I'm going to click save and build. Okay, note the time of the compile that just finished. So what I'm gonna do, because it's firmware.bin now, is remove the USB drive and then reconnect it. And as you can see now, there's only firmware.cur that exists. Okay, I've removed the power for the moment so you can see it boot. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna insert the USB right now. And what you'll see is it'll boot to the Marlin screen. And then it'll boot to the normal operation screen. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.